Hello, everybody, and welcome back to How Do You Do? How do you do? Are you having a good day? I hope so. I am having a wonderful day because we are going to do another theater makeup together. A makeup that I have, this is a role I've never played in a show I've never been in. The show is kind of in the news right now. A lot of people have been talking about this show. I think it's one of the most famous, iconic makeups in all musical theater history. Can you guess what makeup we might be doing? So welcome to the Jellicle Ball. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are doing cat's makeup. We are gonna do this cat's makeup. I've played a lot of cats. I've played the Cat in the Hat quite a few times at Children's Theater, but never in cat makeup. I don't think I've ever done a show at the theater where I've been in full cat makeup. I've done cat makeup on a number of people. I think this is the performer that did the movie from the 90s. They filmed the stage show, and if you wanna watch Cats, watch that. Do not watch the new movie. And then this is the revival. The makeup's changed a little bit. I've been studying these, and this is Munscrap? Moosecrap? Mousecrap? Meowscrap? I should know this. There is no story to Cats. This is my opinion. I think it's the right one. It is just music based on a bunch of poems. I have seen the show. I saw it when I was in high school. It's a silly show. I wish I was a good enough of a dancer to be in it. So today we're gonna do Cats makeup. So I hope you enjoy. Let's see how close I can get to the original show. Woohoo! Okay, let's start by getting ready to do our makeup. I'm having kind of a curly hair day. So I'm gonna just put my hair into a man bun. Pardon my daughter, she's walking like crazy upstairs, which is awesome, but you're gonna hear some bumps and boops today. Kit Kat is sleeping on the lamps. It would be a shame if this is the one How Do You Do video that she does not make an appearance in. Great, so I'm gonna prep my face, get ready for makeup. We are using cream makeup. If you saw our first makeup video, I did a clown face. There'll be some more clown makeups coming of different types of clowns. But I'm using Ben Nye today. This is the gray cat, so we're gonna have white, black, gray. I might make a few alterations because I'm not actually in the show. Because I know that he uses silver to highlight and I don't have a metallic silver on me. So I might throw a few other colors on the eyes just to see what I think. Let my face dry from that. So I've got my mirror, I've got you. Let's get going. We're gonna start with the white and I'm gonna be looking at the picture of the show makeup. But I'm blending the original version and the revival had a few changes in the makeup. It looks very much the same, but there are some subtle differences. And we're gonna start with a bunch of white makeup and I'm gonna basically put a cross shape on my face. A giant, I'm gonna start at the top. I'm gonna go into my hair a little bit. That'll be fun to get out later. I'm gonna go down the nose. So let's apply the white. Here we go. Okay, so I kind of have a cross shape of white on my face. It's very messy looking at the moment. If you watch the clown video, I tend to blend with my fingers, is how I like to blend my makeup. A lot of people use a beauty blender, I think that's what I call them, these little sponges. And I might use one for some of this because there's quite a few colors going on, so I'll probably use a little bit of both. But I'm not gonna smooth this out. This looks pretty like I ran into something full of makeup. What I'm gonna do is put the gray on, and then we're gonna work on blending this. The base for this cat, I think, is a very smooth, soft transition between the white and the gray. When I've done old age makeup or a cat or a villain, makeup is really highlights and shadows or highlights and lowlights. So in this makeup, the white is gonna be contoured by the darker colors. If I was to do old age, I do tend to make them more gaunt. I guess what I'm trying to say is a lot of makeups, depending on the colors you use, feel about the same. Cats are very angular. Reminds me a lot of a type of drag makeup. I'm gonna try to make my eyes look really bright and angled, and I want my face to look a little sharper and pointed like a cat. And I just saw Kit Kat.
Kit Kat!
Kit Kat, we're doing cat makeup! Come here! This is your show! I'll put your makeup on later. Okay, we're gonna put the gray in. Here we go. All right, so I've got some gray and some white. It looks very messy. So I'm gonna go in with my sponge blender and I'm gonna start making this look a little bit more intentional and specific, a little bit more symmetrical too. So I'm gonna go for that. And I wish my gray was a bit darker. I might soften this up and then throw a little black in there, so even on the far out spots, even looks a little bit more dynamic looking. So here we go, see how this goes. All right, so I've got some white and gray kind of going on. I'm gonna go in now with a brush and kind of sharpen this, some of this up before I powder. So I think it's looking kind of fun. It's new, I did not practice this. So this is my first time attempting this one. First, I'm gonna go in with my white. What I would like to do is get this a little bit more specific looking. I wanna work on the shape of my eyes and the muzzle and the forehead and the neck, and then I'll probably powder and then go in, start my brush work. It's kind of like an airbrush painting, this first layer, and then I'll go in with my, what I like to think of as like the equivalent of a Sharpie and crisp it all up. And I might even play with some blush tones to make it look even softer. So at this point, I'm gonna work on the cat, literally the cat eye. Now that I've played with some grays, I feel like most of my white is just a notch softer, a little grayer, not as bright. So I wanna brighten up the white spots. This is where I'm gonna start getting a little bit of an angle on my face, hopefully. A famous cat eye. And I'll do some more blending. I forgot there's a gray nose before the black. Let's put some gray on there. So I switched back to my finger. My finger is like my painting tool, and I've been doing makeup for quite a while. I use all tools. I use a lot of brushes. I do like the beauty blender, especially if I'm doing like a normal, like I'm trying to look like me on stage. I'm not an animal or something, to blend kind of street makeup. I do prefer blending with my fingers. Okay. Got a little bit too instead. Everything with the cat makeup is a, most of it at this point, what I'm trying to do is make soft transitions. So it doesn't go white, gray, black. It goes whoosh, softly shifts from color, almost like light. I don't want it to look streaky or greasy, so trying to make it look soft. I've never met an actor that was in Cats. I would love to meet one, talk about their makeup, how long it takes them to do. I bet if you're in a show, a lot of those big shows, or even shows with the children's theater, when you first learn a new makeup, it can take hours. I wonder if you're in Cats, how quickly they get it down. Right now I'm making discoveries as I go. So I've done really epic makeups that are probably this amount of makeup. I bet if I knew what I was doing, if I had practiced, I bet I could do this in 35 minutes, 40 minutes. If I really didn't have to think about it, just do it. I also want this to angle a little bit. This was looking a little squarish to me. Kind of ruined that shape. Let's do this and this. How many of you have cats at home, I wonder? Cats are my favorite animal, I have to say, especially in the wild. I love big cats, if they're left in the wild. All right, so I like the gray on the sides. I wanna work on my muzzle a little bit, this part. And I think before I do that, I wanna darken the gray just a little bit more. So this little, it's kind of, these are called smile lines. One of my clown faces, I use those. And why I think cat makeup looks really good on the human face is we have some features that are similar to a cat. So if you paint your face and follow the movement of your face, the cat makeup doesn't look like it's just sitting on your face, it actually moves with your face. I'm trying to get this gray line to move with my eyebrows. Right now, the darker I put this gray on, then when I put the white back on it to muzzle, it'll be a contrast. So I'm just gonna darken. I'm actually gonna put some darker colors where I don't want it, where I know I want it to be white. That way when I put the muzzle back on, the muzzle is what I call that little, in a cartoon, it's usually that white spot where the whiskers are. I'm not a veterinarian, I'm calling that the muzzle. Maybe it's called something else. I'm also trying to keep a very, this line from gray to white that I want it to be soft, but I want it to hit where my cheekbones are. Also, this is going to give me that kind of cat. It also will move with my face. I don't want it to be too harsh of a line. It needs to be that, again, it's a very blended line. So I'm kind of going back and forth. I'm kind of bringing the gray into the white, then I'm bringing the white back onto the gray. All right, so let's go back and put all that white on now. All right, that's the base for my cat makeup. I think that's looking pretty cool. I am just gonna make sure I like my angles. I think this needs to go just a touch higher. And this side needs to go a little touch higher and prep. I'm just gonna pound out any wrinkles where I think there's still a little bit too much makeup, so when I powder it's nice and smooth, and then we'll get to go into some brush work. Let's powder.
Because jellicles can and jellicles do, jellicles can and jellicles do.
Let me look at you, Kit Kat. Let me look at your face. Do we look the same? Do we look like brother and sister? No? Say hi, Kit Kat. She's not in the mood. All right, we are powdered and we look like we're getting somewhere. Oh, I would love to be in this show. If I had to start every day putting this much makeup on, I'd be very happy. I'm gonna introduce some new makeup things. I've been using, I should have showed you all. This is my white, my gray, my black. These are my Ben Nye cream makeups that are creamy and oily and wet, and I've powdered them. So I'm gonna keep using some of those. I'm also gonna incorporate some makeup pencils, some blushes, some black. I'm gonna get some different width of brushes because I might want some thicker lines and smaller lines. This is powder in colors. I'm just gonna put almost another layer of what I just did just to even make this look a little richer. Painting makeup is just like painting a painting in my mind. When you are, it is, I guess that's not the most profound statement, but it does feel like trying to highlight and shadows. That's all I'm doing over and over again. All right, so I'm gonna start with putting some white in. Just make sure my brushes are clean. So I've just got, this has got a little shimmer to it. This is just a white powder. I'm just gonna put it on top of the areas that I want really white. And then I'm gonna go in with a black and very lightly, just to soften that transition line. Go in with my dark color, my black, and I don't want it to go too black, so I'm gonna start the furthest away and see how that just kind of, see the difference? And then when I put my sharp lines on top, it'll have this wonderful, hopefully wonderful base. Sharpen that up a little bit. Yeah, it's starting to look good. All right, let's do some lines. This is the part where if I make a mistake, it's really hard to go back. I've kind of been able to make things get a little brighter and a little darker at this point, but once we start actual lines, it gets a little bit harder. I've got three different size brushes, a small, medium, and a large. I think I'm gonna start more towards the top and work my way down. Now, in the two reference photos, the big difference is his eyebrow is white and there's an eyebrow above it, and this makeup, where this was the original and they kind of adjusted it for this. It might be because of the performer or a different design. This one, they kept the line and used his eyebrows. So I think based on how my face works, my eyebrows, truth be told, I wax my eyebrows because they're very large, and so usually there's more room for makeup. And we in this, I can't get to my waxer right now. So I think I'm going to incorporate my eyebrows. So I'm gonna use a pencil and I think mark a few lines, and then I'll move in with paint. The hardest thing is they keep this area pretty white. So I'm gonna do some lines. Then we'll go with a brush and the cream makeup again that'll have to be powdered. I'm actually not liking this. It's getting, looks like charcoal. I'm gonna go right in with the brush. Painting with pencils can sometimes feel like crayons. You know, crayons aren't as smooth as markers. Markers tend to look a bit smoother when you're working with crayons and markers. Cream makeup tends to look a little more like a sharper and sleeker. And I want this part, these lines, to do that. That's the beginning of the eyebrow. I'm gonna put my reference shot again. Now for the hard part, the eye. And what this is gonna do is we're gonna go over my eyelid, keeping it white. So I'm gonna start on, I like to start on my right side because I'm better with that, and then I match it with the left. And then I'm gonna try to leave that part white, but I want this part on the end to go dark again. So I'm gonna start at the end of my eye and connect it to this cat eye shape. And then I'm gonna fill it in just a little bit on the outside. So I wanna leave that line white, but have it be darker out here. And then, see how that's a very sharp, that just goes black white? I want that to get softer. And I think to do that, I'm going to use a blush brush, but I'm gonna use a little bit of this cream makeup and a little bit of my shadow. I might throw a little white makeup on top of my eyelids again at the end to brighten up. So that's the top eye. Now that I think that worked, I'm gonna thicken up the eyebrows a bit, and then I'm gonna work on underneath the eye, then the hardest part, the inside of the eye. Isn't it crazy how much makeup this is to help a person look like a cat? I'm starting to look a little stripey, which is good, like I've got those cat stripes. I'm also, some areas I want to be very crisp, and some areas I'm letting it be a little fur-like. I'll show you what I mean here. Like these ends of these lines, I'm not making them look like a marker. I'm letting them get a little chalky and scratchy, which I think will help it look a little fur-like. All right, let's get ready to do inside of the eye. It's gonna be a little bit more of a challenge. Same thing, I'm gonna try to leave this part white, so I wanna bring this in. And this is all trying to angle. That one worked, let's see if we could do it again on the other side. I hear you, Kit Kat, I hear you. Are you practicing your jellicle song? That's the beginning of the cat eye. I'm gonna push a little white on the eyelid and powder this so this all stays put, and we'll keep working our way down. Rare. All right. Same thing as before, I'm gonna put a little of that white powder, my white, not my white setting powder, but my color white. Just on those white parts that I want a bit whiter. With the black. Just a little black powder just on the outsides of the eyes so those really get dark out there. Right on the outside. All right, that's my cat eye. Let's move on to the nose. The eyes, I think, are probably one of the hardest parts of doing this makeup. Nose time. All right, so I'm gonna do the nose and the mouth part, which is probably, I think, the part that makes this feel the most cat-like besides the eyes. If you go do a round shape, you'll get a little bit more dog, canine looking. And then if you go straight across, you get a little bit more of a cat look. So I'm gonna put a pretty straight line, and I'm not gonna cover all of my nostrils, just a little bit. So I'm gonna start with that straight line. I might even switch to a slightly smaller brush here. And I want this line to be super sharp. Switch back to my big brush. I'm getting a little bit inside my nose. And now I'm gonna go down the center of my nose. I'm trying to clean up the outer edge of the line just a little bit. There's my little nose. I've got that little gray bit there. Now I'm gonna do a very small line from my nose to my lip. And it's hopefully a little fatter at the top, a bit skinnier like that. And now I'm gonna cover just my top lip, and I'm gonna go extend my top lip just a little bit. If you watch the clown video, ooh, I just have the eyebrows. I want to leave my bottom lip white, and I want the top lip to go black. And because this is cream makeup, it could get all over the place until I powder it. So I'm gonna have to leave my mouth open, and put the color on it. Because if I put my white lip on the black lip before I powder, the black will transfer onto the bottom lip. So I'm gonna sound like this, and then I'm gonna powder. Oh, not. Another trick is to blow out your nose with air when you're powdering your nose. Otherwise, you will get a little powder in there. Same thing with your mouth. So there's the top lip, and I just wanted to see how symmetrical that is. Okay, and now that I can close my mouth, I'm gonna put my little extenders on. I'm letting them curve up, just a little curve. Kind of look like a Joker a little bit. All right, I'm gonna powder that. I might thicken that up at the end, but. And I'm gonna just darken the tip of my nose. Now it's time for a bunch of fur lines. Fur lines. So I'm gonna add my stripes on the outer side and on the chin and around the muzzle. He has these very faint little whisker lines on the white part and then more traditional kind of bigger whiskers. So I'm gonna work from the middle, inside out. Because jellicles can and jellicles do. And then I have kind of some streaks coming down. One there, one there, and these can look, I don't want them to get too messy looking, but they get to be a little messy looking. I think he has three. And I want them to be wider on the closer to my hairline and thinner as they get closer to my face. Great. And we're so close. And now we need a little white makeup to highlight these lines. I also need to put a few more lines on my eyebrows, like this. Okay. Let's do some highlighting. Highlight is on the top of a line, you want it brighter, and underneath it, you want it darker, almost like a shadow of something. So just by putting a bright white on top of some of these, it's gonna give it a little better look. All right, meow. I want to just thicken up my mouth line just a little bit, and then I think we have a cat face, and I'll put the wig on, and maybe a little cat top I have in my puppet shop. All right, everybody. So I'm putting some mascara on. And the last thing I want to do is seal this with my final seal. This will brighten the colors up a little bit. And then we'll put my wig on and hold my breath and spray myself down. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. And that is my cat's, Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber's Cats, the musical makeup. Oh, this old thing? Oh yeah, I could do this all day. I would wear this all day long if I could. Let's see. Oops. This wig is a little, it's not really a Cats the Musical wig, so I'm putting a ponytail in the back for some fur I don't want. I have a cat mullet that I don't want to have. Trying to keep those up almost like hair or ears. Let me get a little bit more fur. Do you see how happy I am? I'm just happy because I have this makeup on. Hi, everybody. Well, welcome to Cat the Musical. I'm all by myself. Kit Kat, where are you? Kit Kat, this is your moment. This is our big moment. Where are you? I'll have to find her. Thank you for joining. How do you do? This is my Cats the Musical. Let's take a look at the reference. So this is what I was going for. Did I get it? I think so. Not bad for what I could find in my basement. Thank you so much for joining. I hope you enjoy the cat makeup video. It is one of my favorite musicals in a very silly way. Thank you so much for joining. I hope you liked today's tutorial. And if you've got some makeup at home, go try to be a cat. It'll be pretty good. All right. And you know why? Because jellicles can and jellicles do. Jellicles can and jellicles do. Jellicles can and jellicles do. Jellicles can and jellicles do.
Do-do-do. Are you blind when you're born? Can you see in the dark? Can you look at a king? Would you sit on his throne? Can you see with your mind that it's worse than your bark? Are you cock of the book? When you're walking alone, because jellicles are. Jellicles do, jellicles do, and jellicles good, jellicles good.